गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर टी एम दिवाकर, वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ENTC डिपार्टमेंट इन शरद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग. सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कवर सम फंडामेंटल राइट्स. सो वॉट इज ह्यूमन राइट? सो ह्यूमन राइट इट इज refer to the concept of human being as having some universal natural rights or status regardless of legal jurisdictions or other localizing such as ethics, nationalities and sex. So what is the definition of the fundamental rights? So fundamental rights are essential human rights and that are offered to every citizens, but it is irrespective of the caste, race, creeds, place of birth, religion or the gender. In simple, it gives equal protection to all the citizens. So these are equal to freedoms and these rights are essential for personal goods and the society at the large. So there are six fundamental rights. So first one, the rights to equality. Next, the rights to freedom. Next, the rights to freedom from the exploitation. The rights to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights. The rights to constitutional remedies. Let us see one by one. First of all, right to equality means samanta ka adhikar. So there are some articles related to the right of equalities. So article number 4, equality before the law. So it provides that all citizens shall be equally protected by laws of the country. Article number 15, it is related to the social equality and equal access to the public areas, and it provides that no person shall be discriminated on the basis of caste, color, language, etc. Every person shall have equal access to the public places like public parks, museums, wells, temples, etc. Article number 16, it is related to the equality of opportunity in matters of public employment. It provides the equal employment opportunities in state service for all citizens, and no citizen shall be discriminated against in the matter of the public employment or the appointment on the grounds of race, religion, caste, sex, place of birth, descent or residence. Exemptions to this can be made for providing special provisions for the backward classes. Article number 7, it is abolitions of untouchability. It prohibits the practice of untouchability. Untouchability is abolished in all forms. Any disabilities arising out of the untouchability is made an offense. Article number 18 is abolitions of the titles. The state shall not confirm any titles except those which are academic or military titles. The articles also exhibits the citizen of India from accepting any titles from the foreign states. This article abolishes the titles that were awarded by the British, such as Rai Bahadur, Khan Bahadur, etc. Awards like Padma Sri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Bharat Ratna and military honors like Ashok Chakra, Paramveer Chakra do not belong to this category. Next one is the rights to freedom, that is Satantrata ka Adhikar. In this freedom to write, there are some articles. So first one, the freedom of speech and expressions. So this enables an individual to participate in public activities. The freedom of press has not been used in Article 19, but the freedom of expression includes the freedom of press. The second one is the freedom to assemble peacefully without arms, on which the state can impose reasonable restrictions in the interest of public orders and sovereignty and integrity of the India. Freedom to form the associations or unions, on which the state can impose the reasonable restrictions on this freedom in the interest of public orders, morality and the sovereignty and the integrity. Freedom to move freely throughout the territory of the India means through reasonable restrictions can be imposed on this right in the interest of the public's general public. For example, restrictions may be imposed on movement and traveling so as to control the epidemics. Fifth one is the freedom to reside and settle in any part of the territory of the India, which is also subject to reasonable restrictions by the state in the interest of general public or the protection of scheduled tribes, because certain safeguards as are envisaged here seem to be justified to protect indigenous and tribal peoples from the exploitations and coercions. Sixth number, freedom to practice any professionals or to carry on any occupational trade or business on which state may impose reasonable restrictions in the interest of the general public. Thus, there is no right to carry on the business which is dangerous or immoral. Next one is a right against the exploitations. Shoshan ke virudh adhikar. From the figure, you will come to know the ideas about the exploitations. The abolition of trafficking in human being and beggars, that is the forced labors. The abolition of employments of children below the age of 14 years in dangerous jobs like factories and mines. So beggar practiced in the past by landlords has been declared a crime and it is punishable by law. So trafficking in humans for the purpose of slave trades or prostitutional is also prohibited by the law. Article number 23, it says that prohibition of traffic in human being and forced labors. In that part number 1, the traffic in human beings and beggars and other similar form of forced labors are prohibited, and any contraventions of this provision shall be an offense punishable in accordance with the laws. In article number 23 into, it prevents the state from the imposing compulsory services for public services, and in imposing such services the state shall not make any discriminations on grounds only of religion, race, caste or class or any of them. So exploitation implies the misuse of other services by force and or labor without payment. So there were many marginalized communities in India who were forced to engage in manual and agricultural labor without any payment. So labor without payment is known as beggar. Article number 23 forbids any form of exploitations. Also, one cannot be forced to engage in labor against his or her will, even if remuneration is given. Forced labor is forbidden by the constitution, and it is considered forced labor if the less than minimum wage is paid. This article is also bonded labor unconstitutional. Bonded labor is when a person is forced to offer services out of a loan or debit that cannot be repaid. The constitution make coercions of any kind of unconstitutional, thus forcing landless persons into labor and forcing helpless women into the prostitutional is unconstitutional. The article also makes trafficking unconstitutional. So trafficking involves the buying and selling of men and women for illegal and immoral activities. Even though the constitution does not explicitly ban slavery, article number 23 has a wide scope because of the inclusion of the term forced labor and the traffic. Next one is the right to freedom of religion. That is the dharmik swatantrata ka adhikar. The fundamental rights, rights to freedom of religion. So religion is a matter of personal belief and values, and that is why choosing a religion is considered as a fundamental rights in India under the Act, Rights to Freedom of Religion. If anyone believes in any particular religion, then it does not affect anyone particularly. Thus, there are many constitutions in the world that give you the right to the freedom of religion. So according to the constitution, all religions are equal before the state and no religions shall be given preference over others. Citizens are free to preach, practice and propagate any religion of their choice. Religious communities can set up charitable institutions of their own. Activities in such institutional which are not religion are performed according to the law laid down by the government, and no person shall be compelled to pay the taxes for the promotion of the particular religion. A state-run institution cannot impart education that is pro-religion. Last one is the cultural and educational rights, that is the Sanskriti or Shiksha Sambandhi Adhikars. Article number 29 and 30, it gives the cultural and educational rights. So any community which has a language and a script of its own has the right to conserve and develop it. So all minorities, religious or linguistic, can set up their own educational institutes to preserve and develop their own culture. Last one is the right to constitutional remedies. Samvaidhanik upcharo ka adhikar. Rights to constitutional remedies empowers the citizens to move a court of law in case of any denial of the fundamental rights. So this procedure of asking the court to preserve or safeguard the citizens' fundamental rights can be done in various ways. The court can issue the various kinds of writs. These writs are habeas corpus, mandamus, prohibitions, quo warranto, certiorari, like this. So what is a writ? So writs are written order issued by the Supreme Court of India to provide the constitutional remedies in order to protect the fundamental rights of citizens from the violations. So fact about the writ in India. Article number 32 also empowers parliaments to authorize any other courts to issue these writs. So before 1950, only the High Courts of Calcutta, Bombay and Madras had the power to issue the writs. Article number 226 empowers all the High Courts of India to issue the writs. The writs of India are borrowed from English law, where they are known as prerogative writs. So what is writ? Petitions. Writ petition is essentially a court petitions for extraordinary review, asking court to interview in a lower court decisions. Under the Indian legal system, jurisdictions to issue the prerogative writs is given to the Supreme Court and to the High Court of Jurisdiction of all Indian states. Part of law related to writs are set forth in the Constitution of India. So what are the types of writs? The Constitution empowers the Supreme Court and the High Courts to issue the order of the writs. The type of writs are habeas corpus, certiorari, prohibitions, mandamus, quo warranto. So thank you.